Hello and welcome to Kashmir Now. I'm your host, Surbhi Sharma. Let's take a look at some stories of this week's episode. European think tank deliberates on illegal implication of CPEC on Gilgit-Baltistan. Human rights activists oppose Pakistan's expansionist agendas in the illegally occupied territories. Indoor sports academies giving boost to martial arts in Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu University holds 7-day-long national workshop on Indian scripts. Later, we will take you to explore small yet beautiful hill station of Kufri in Himachal Pradesh in our special edition of Incredible India. Experts and academics recently deliberated upon the legal implications of the China-Pakistan economic corridor during a 2-day conference in Germany. They highlighted that illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan, from where the CPEC passes, is an integral part of Jammu and Kashmir, and neither Pakistan nor China has any legal rights or claim over it, a report.
Junaid Qureshi, the director of European Foundation for South Asian Studies, or IFSAS, recently examined the legal implications of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, or CPEC, with regard to Kashmir and, in turn, the Gilgit-Baltistan region through which the corridor passes. Speaking at the 2-day conference of South Asia experts and academics in Germany, Qureshi asserted that Beijing signing the CPEC with Pakistan was a total disregard to the international norms and practices, and it further impeded the resolution of Kashmir issue. Qureshi further underscored the fact that Gilgit-Baltistan, illegally occupied by Pakistan, is an integral part of Jammu and Kashmir, and neither Pakistan or China have any legal right or claim over it.
Controlled by Pakistan since the first Kashmir war, Gilgit-Baltistan has never been formally and legally integrated into the Pakistani state and does not participate in Pakistan's constitutional affairs, as subsequent Pakistani administrations have argued that the Pakistani state cannot officially integrate Gilgit-Baltistan into Pakistan in line with its claimed, yet not practiced, position that a referendum should be carried out across the whole of the region, and that any such step would prejudice its international obligations with regard to the Jammu and Kashmir conflict.
Activists have long raised concerns over China-Pakistan economic corridor, saying that the flagship project, which was floated at the pretext of bringing prosperity to the region, had only brought death and destruction to the region. The CPEC project has created a significant demographic change in the region, with large labor force coming in from China and Pakistan. The indigenous people were getting marginalized in their own territory. They also blame that both China and Pakistan are committing war crimes and genocides in Gilgit-Baltistan.
The said state subject rule was abrogated in Gilgit-Baltistan in 1974. By the government of Pakistan, which resulted in demographic changes in the territory. And in 2009, the Gilgit-Baltistan Empowerment and Self-Governance Order was passed by the Pakistani cabinet. The order granted self-rule to the people of Gilgit-Baltistan by creating, among other things, an elected Gilgit-Baltistan Legislative Assembly and Gilgit-Baltistan Council. Yet the indigenous people did not gain control over their national resources and minerals, as all decision-making powers in relation to forest, power, tourism, and minerals are under the direct control of this newly created Gilgit-Baltistan Council, which is headed by the Prime Minister of Pakistan.
Although amendments were made to Gilgit-Baltistan Order 2009 and a new legislation was put in place promising greater autonomy to the region, the new Gilgit-Baltistan Order 2018 once again vested all the powers in the autocratic rulers sitting in Islamabad. China-Pakistan Economic Corridor traversing through Gilgit-Baltistan is one such manifestation of diabolic designs Pakistan has been hatching to increase their stakes in the illegally occupied territory. Pakistan's geopolitical expansion in the territory is keenly monitored by the international bodies and the residents of Gilgit-Baltistan. A major flare-up could be witnessed if Pakistan does not pull its feet back from the region.
To speak more on this, we are now joined by an expert on the issue. Recently, a think tank, European Foundation for South Asian Studies, held a conference to discuss the implications of CPEC corridor on Gilgit-Baltistan. Sir, what implications do you see on the locals in Gilgit-Baltistan?
Construction of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, which is passing through the Pakistan-occupied Kashmir of Gilgit-Baltistan and Sarkardu, is now throwing up a lot of challenges to the local population over there. One, the main challenge to them is that their farmland, productive farmland that was there, that has been forcibly taken away, and this corridor is passing through a lot of that area. These people had protested to the Pakistan government over there that, look, why did you change the alignment of this road so that our fertile farmland is not taken away? But no heed is given to them. So what is happening is, now as it is, this area, there is no industry as such. Livelihood is very scarce to earn and very difficult to earn. There are no jobs over there. What was touted as jobs to be given to the locals in the construction of this China-Pakistan economic corridor has not been there, because the Chinese authorities have got their own labor from China itself. They are getting their own steel, they are getting their own cement. The only thing that they have taken over there from the Pakistanis is the land. And that land is the fertile land over there. Therefore, what is going to happen in the coming years is that the farmers, first of all, who are being deprived of the land, will not be able to grow their own crops. They will become dependent on buying food, which again will be a problem, because there are no jobs over there. And how are these people going to live?
Do you think CPEC project is a part of Pakistan's geopolitical expansion plan in this illegally occupied territory?
Earlier also, they had ceded a part of this area to China, wherein China became more closer and it could construct the Karakoram Highway. And now, with this CPEC project coming in over there, Pakistan is illegally trying to settle its claim on this land, that, look, this land is ours. China is doing again an illegal thing, because this land is basically belongs to the erstwhile Jammu and Kashmir state of India, which was under the Maharaja Hari Singh at the time of the independence. And the instrument of accession signed by the Maharaja Hari Singh was very clear in its terms. It was the same instrument of accession that was signed by the rest of the 435 states, princely states of India. Therefore, this portion of land is land of Jammu and Kashmir state. And as per law, after the Maharaja signed the instrument of accession, this land belongs to India.
Thanks for sharing your thoughts with us. Moving on, Pakistan's geopolitical expansionist agendas in the territories of Gilgit-Baltistan and POK have drawn widespread criticism from international communities and the indigenous population in recent times. Although a slew of protests erupted across the illegally occupied regions, Pakistan does not seem to budge from the status quo. In this scenario, many activists have come to the fore challenging the increasing authoritarian attitude of Islamabad in these two territories, a report.
Unabated torture, genocides and enforced disappearances at the hands of Pakistani military have become a common fate for the persecuted residents of illegally occupied territories. In recent times, many human rights groups and activists have risen up against Pakistan's oligarchy in Gilgit-Baltistan and POK. But gaining a unanimous support from international community has always been a challenge. In a bid to shake up residents of these regions and gather international attention towards Pakistan's growing presence in the illegally occupied territories, human rights activist Shabir Chaudhry sent out a strong message for the people of Kashmir.
सवाल ये पैदा होता है कि अगर आप पाकिस्तानियों को इंसाफ नहीं दे सके उन पर आप जुल्म करते रहे हैं और जो मुसलमान हैं बलोचिस्तान के वो भी अभी भी रो रहे हैं पीट रहे हैं कि अब हमारे इतने जहरू लोग हैं कोई कहता है जी मेरा बाप किधर गया कोई कहता है जी मेरा भाई किधर गया कोई कहता है जी मेरा बेटा किधर गया गायब है हजारों के हिसाब से टेंस एंड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ बलोच पीपल आर मिसिंग तो आप उनको इंसाफ नहीं दे सके वो भी पाकिस्तानी थे पाकिस्तानी हैं अनलेस आप उनको मजबूर करके बांग्लादेश बना दें तो और बात है आप पश्तूनों को जो है ना इंसाफ नहीं दे सके वो बेचारे लदा रो रहे हैं सिंधी जो हैं वो भी आपने रोना रो रहे हैं कि हमारे साथ नाइंसाफ़ी हो रही है भाई अगर वो इलाके जिन लोगों ने कुछ ना कुछ करदार अदा किया पाकिस्तान बनाने में और जो पाकिस्तान का एक लिहाज से हर हिस्सा माने जाते हैं आप उनको किसी तरह का इंसाफ नहीं दे सके तो हम इतने बेवकूफ़ हैं
The activist underlined gross human rights violations Pakistan has carried out in its occupied province of Balochistan for several decades. Thousands of Pashtuns and Sindhis who make the ethnic population of Balochistan became victims of extrajudicial killings and enforced disappearances. The seekers of justice and representation in Pakistan Assembly were meted out with severe brutality by Pakistani military.
जो पाकिस्तानी हैं उनको इंसाफ दे सके तो वो नॉन पाकिस्तानियों को यानी गांव जो जम्मू कश्मीर के साथी हैं जो शहरी हैं जो कश्मीरी इलादा कौम है उनको आप इंसाफ दे देंगे भाई मैं कम से कम इस पर यकीन करने के लिए तैयार नहीं हूँ ये लड़ाई लड़ना पहले दिन से ही या शुरू का अपनी ज़िंदगी की शुरुआत में ही ये पाकिस्तान के से में आया कि ना खुद आराम से रहना ना किसी को आराम से रहने देना है हमारी पॉलिसी जो होगी खारजा पॉलिसी वो लड़ाई पर मबनी नहीं होगी हमारी बुनियाद जो होगी वो दोस्ती पर होगी
The majority of people in Gilgit-Baltistan and POK seem resented with the status of illegally occupied territories by Pakistan. The common sentiment of freedom has now perfused citizens of the two regions. Till now, the activists and residents have been following a peaceful way to resolve the issue of Kashmir, but the deep-rooted anger could anytime snowball into a major protest against Pakistan's autocracy.
Moving on to Jammu and Kashmir, where martial arts have gained immense popularity in recent years. And giving this popularity a new high, several indoor sports academies have come up in the state that are offering martial art courses to all age groups. These academies are not only boosting the spirit of sport lovers, but are also helping them to practice during winters when sport activities usually come to stand still, especially in Kashmir Valley. So today, let us take you to one such newly opened academy in Srinagar, which, with its latest equipment, is drawing the attention of several youngsters. Have a look. Martial art in Jammu and Kashmir has gained maximum resonance among the grassroots. Be it young or old, the fever of martial art seems to have taken everyone in its grip. Several indoor sports academies have also started up in the state to satisfy this hunger of people to learn martial arts and keep the sporting spirit raised among people even during winters. One such academy in Srinagar is catching the fancy of many youngsters nowadays. Affiliated to Jammu and Kashmir Academy of Unified Martial Arts, the academy offers courses to the people of all the ages. With some of the high-quality breaking boards, kick shields, mats, punching bags, stability balls, dummies and gloves available with it, along with several other facilities provided to the sport persons, the academy is looking forward to produce champions for the nation in martial arts.
जैसे हमने फील किया कि बच्चों को यहाँ पे बहुत प्रॉब्लम हो रही है इंडोर गेम्स के बारे में जैसे उनको इक्विपमेंट्स नहीं मिलते हैं परफेक्ट इक्विपमेंट्स ताकि वो बाहर जाके जो कम्पीट करना होता है कंपटीशन उसमें प्रॉब्लम होती है तो इसलिए हमने जो यहाँ पे एकेडमी खोली इसमें हमने नए इक्विपमेंट्स बाहर से भी मंगाए और भी इक्विपमेंट्स आ रहे हैं लाइक हमने यहाँ पे पंचिंग बैग्स डमीज जो हैं وہ چیزیں ہم نے نئی نئی جو انٹرنیشنل اسٹینڈارڈ میں ہوتی ہے وہ چیزیں ہم نے لائی. تو اسی لیے ہم نے یہ اکیڈمی کا انیشیٹو لے لیا. اور اس میں ہم نے ایک چیز کیا رکھا, جو ہم نے پک اینڈ ڈراپ فیسلٹی رکھی ہے اس میں, اور جو آفس گوئنگ جو لیڈیز ہوتی ہے ان کے لیے فزیبل ٹائمنگ رکھی تاکہ وہ بھی آ سکے یہاں پہ اور فزیکل فٹ ہو سکے. تو یہ چیزیں ہم نے رکھی ہے بچوں سے لے کر بڑوں تک, میریڈ ہو یا ان میریڈ ہو, ان کے لیے ہم نے یہاں پہ یہ اکیڈمی رکھی ہے.
Every day during the wee hours of morning, the academy comes alive with the sound of kicks, swings and punches when young children gather here for practice. Encouraging self-defense and physical fitness, the academy trains people in different forms of martial arts.
میں ایک لڑکی ہوں, مجھے کافی اچھا لگا. اینڈ اس سے ہم سیلف ڈیفنس سے ہم اویئر ہوتے ہیں ہمارے ان ایکسپیکٹڈ سچویشنس کے لیے. اس سے ہمارا مینٹل اور فزیکل ہیلتھ جو ہے وہ ٹھیک رہتا ہے. اور یہ صرف اسکول یا کالج گوئنگ لڑکیوں کے لیے نہیں ہے, اس میں جو وومن جو کام کرتی ہے وہ بھی آ سکتی ہے. اور یہاں پہ فیمیل ٹرینرس ہیں جن کی وجہ سے ہمیں کافی آسانی ہوتی ہے یہاں پہ چیزیں سیکھنے کے لیے.
ہاں, یہاں پہ بہت اچھی طریقے سے سیکھ پائیں گے ہم مارشل آرٹ, کیونکہ یہاں ویل ٹرینرز ہیں, اچھے اچھے کوچز ہیں جنہوں نے وہ خود بھی انٹرنیشنل پلیئرز ہیں, نیشنل پلیئرز ہیں.
مارشل آرٹ ہیز اے ونڈرفل ہسٹری ان جموں اینڈ کشمیر, اینڈ دیر آر سیورل پلیئرز فرام دی اسٹیٹ ہو ہیو اٹینڈ بوتھ فیم اینڈ فیٹ ایٹ نیشنل ایز ویل ایز انٹرنیشنل لیول ان دی گیم. Lately, many new players have joined this list. Surya Bhanu Pratap Singh, he won bronze at 2018 Asian Games in Jakarta, becoming the first one from the state to achieve this feat. Azmat Bibi, she won bronze in the 9th Commonwealth Karate Championship held in South Africa's Durban. Moreover, in the recently held 3rd World Square Martial Art event in South Korea, Jammu and Kashmir bagged 5 gold medals. Hanaya Nisa in the sub-junior category, while Noor Al-Haya and Mehnoor Bashir in the junior category. Salma Rashid and Ehsan Ul-Haq Boda won the medals in the senior category. Seeing the craze of martial arts among the youngsters of the valley, several academies have now opened up under Jakauma, which is one of the fastest growing sports body in the state and aims to promote martial art activities in Jammu and Kashmir. Youngsters too are eagerly joining up these academies and are putting their heart and soul out while practicing.
Hum yahan pe martial arts sikhate hain, self defense hai. Like dekhiye, girls ke liye aajkal ke daur mein girls ke liye self defense bahut hi zaruri hai. تو گرلز کے لیے یہاں پہ سیلف ڈیفینس بھی سکھایا جاتا ہے اینڈ مارشل آرٹ کی پریکٹس بھی یہاں پہ ہم کراتے ہیں.
تو کس طرح کی پریکٹسنگ آپ کراتے ہیں
یہاں پہ؟ ہم پورا مارشل آرٹ ہم ان کو سکھاتے ہیں. لائک یہاں پہ ٹائیکوانڈو کی پریکٹس ہوتی ہے, کراٹے, جیتکوانڈو, ووشو وغیرہ, ہر کسی ٹائپ کی مارشل آرٹس کی پریکٹس ہم ان کو کرا سکتے ہیں. ابھی تک تو ٹھیک ریسپانس ملا بچوں سے, خاص کر گرلز سے بھی ٹھیک ریسپانس ملا. تو ابھی تک شکر اللہ کا ٹھیک ریسپانس ملا بچوں سے, ایڈمیشنز لے رہے ہیں بچے.
In recent years, the state of Jammu and Kashmir has been laying immense stress in equipping children with various forms of martial arts, either by hosting a number of tournaments or by organizing workshops. And now with the state geared up to provide proper coaching to children in martial arts by opening indoor academies, the country will soon have a large chunk of players coming from Jammu and Kashmir. It is rightly said that a person without the knowledge of his past history, origin and culture is like a tree with no roots. This quote aptly sums up the motive of Jammu University behind organizing a national level workshop on Indian scripts that contains seeds of pristine human knowledge and form foundation of Indian culture.
India has the oldest and the largest collection of ancient scripts that contain a huge treasure of knowledge but have not been decoded yet due to the lack of awareness among people about them. But now efforts are being made by several government authorities to create an aptitude among people about these old scripts so that they can further propagate them. The organizing of 7-day long workshop on Indian scripts by Jammu University's Sanskrit department was also one such attempt in this direction, so as to ensure this cultural relic of the country is preserved for present and future generations. Nearly 70 participants, both young and old from different fields, attended the workshop, and we're really happy to be a part of such an event where they got to know about the country's rich repository of knowledge.
जो एक civilization या community है, वो culture से है और culture root से है. और हम जितनी मर्जी अंग्रेजी पढ़ लें, roots जो हमारे हैं, वो basically देवनागरी में, टाकरी में, इन scripts में हैं. और मुझे लगता है कि अंग्रेज़ी अपनी जगह है, इंटरनेशनल लैंग्वेज है, हम उसे डिनाई नहीं कर सकते अगर हमें दुनिया के साथ कदम से कदम मिला के चलना है. लेकिन शाखाएं तो तभी बढ़ती हैं जब रूट्स मजबूत हों. तो हम रूट से कट चुके हैं. तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा है यहाँ आके, क्योंकि एक वो जैसे कहते हैं ना, जुड़ना ज़मीन से, वो एक फीलिंग आई.
बिकॉज पहले हमें भी इतना नहीं पता था कि हमारी हिस्ट्री में इतनी ज़्यादा स्क्रिप्ट्स हैं, और यहाँ पे इतने इतने डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट से लोग आए हैं, तो ऑब्वियसली थोड़ा सा दूसरों का भी पता चला इतना ज्यादा. तो अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस रहा अभी तक.
Our country and its rich heritage spanning over to more than 2 millennia is a storehouse of ancient manuscripts that contain number of languages about which very less people know. In total, there are 22 major languages in the country, written in 13 different scripts with over 720 dialects. During the workshop, the participants were taught about the basics of these languages contained in various ancient scripts like Brahmi, Sarda and Takri. The history of these languages and other aspects were also discussed with them.
जो वर्कशॉप है ये बहुत ही अच्छा वर्कशॉप रहा है, 7 days का वर्कशॉप. यहाँ पे हमने जो भी हमारे पुराने लिपियाँ हैं, जो जहाँ से एक्चुअली हमारी जो लैंग्वेजेस और फर्दर जो आज हम लोग स्क्रिप्ट्स यूज़ कर रहे हैं, वो जो डिराइव हुई हैं, हम उनका रूट्स में जाके इनको पढ़ रहे हैं. एंड ऑल्सो क्योंकि मैं इंग्लिश डिपार्टमेंट से आना, मैं रिसर्च स्कॉलर, तो मैं ये बताना चाहती हूँ कि इन मैन्यूस्क्रिप्ट, इन पांडुलिपियों में बहुत सारा जो है स्कोप है जहाँ से हम अपने कल्चरल रूट्स तक पहुँच सकते हैं. एंड आई थिंक कि पीपल फ्रॉम अदर डिपार्टमेंट्स ऑल्सो दे शुड कम एंड लर्न दीज स्क्रिप्ट, बिकॉज देयर इज सो मच ऑफ इनहेरिटेंट नॉलेज इन दीज. एंड क्योंकि हम बींग अ रिसर्चर, हमें पहले अपने कल्चर को जानने की ज़रूरत है रादर देन कि हम किसी और के कल्चर को पढ़ें.
Such workshops as the one held in the University of Jammu should be organized on a regular basis across the country, as they will not only help connecting people with their roots but also keep the tradition and literature alive in their hearts.
Next, we move to our section of Incredible India, where we will take you to visit one of the most interesting destinations of Himachal Pradesh. That no less resembles like a paradise, especially during winters. Popularly known as Kufri, this tiny chilly hilly station is famous for hiking, skiing, beautiful scenery and fantastic weather, and attracts thousands of tourists every year. Have a look.
Located around 13 kilometers away from Shimla, Kufri, with its spectacular snow peaks and convoluted topography, is a great choice for tourists as a winter getaway. Best known as ski destination due to its oldest skiing slopes, Kufri also forms the golden triangle of Himachal Pradesh along with Shimla and Chaina. It is famous for its nature parks and picnic spots, among which Hip Hip Hooray amusement park serves as the major attraction. Located amidst the verdant surrounding on Shimla-Kufri highway, this amusement park is the only park in India located at a height of 8,500 feet and can only be reached by ponies. The sprawling complex is spread over an area of 5,000 square meters and is an excellent hideaway for leisure and adventure seekers, and offer activities like Burma Bridge crossing, flying fox and commando net. Tourists who throng Kufri during winter season never miss to visit this amusement park that has a plethora of fun activities.
Winters is the best time to come to Kufri. I mean, है तो पूरा साल ही आप आ सकते हैं यहाँ पे, लेकिन winters के अंदर जो tourist आता है वो काफ़ी खुश होकर जाता है, because यहाँ पे स्कीइंग, स्नो सर्फिंग और ये काफ़ी एक्टिविटीज़ रहती हैं. पर्टिकुलरली कुछ ऐसे पॉइंट्स हैं जो थोड़े कोल्ड जोन है कुफरी के अंदर, एंड वी हैव एक्सपेक्टेड अर्ली, आई मीन वी हैव हैड अर्ली स्नोफॉल दिस ईयर, तो कुछ ऐसी सर्टन एरियाज हैं जहाँ पे आप स्कीइंग कर सकते हैं, स्नो सर्फिंग कर सकते हैं, एंड लॉट ऑफ स्नो एक्टिविटीज आर देयर एंड आवर प्लेस इज वन ऑफ देम.
Swimming pool that turns into an ice skating rink in the winters is major draw for tourists in the park. With the help of trainers who are present near the ice rink, they perform this activity and gather a fabulous experience. Skiing is another wonderful activity for the adventure junkies to try out in this park. Gentle slopes that are covered with layers of snow make for some incredible skiing experience. Along with this, one can also try tobogganing, an adventure activity that includes sliding down the hill on a sledge.
इसमें क्या होता है, अपने आप नेचुरल आइस बन जाते हैं इसमें, तो उसमें क्या है कि काफी अच्छा जो है टूरिस्ट आता है यहाँ पर आइस स्केटिंग जो है करते हैं, फुल एंजॉय करते हैं. इनको ट्रेनिंग करने में लमसम हमारे को 5 से 10 मिनट लगते हैं, थोड़ा इनमें बॉडी बैलेंस बनाना पड़ता है, तो उससे ऐसा होता है कि थोड़ा बंदे आगे करना शुरू कर देते हैं.
काफ़ी स्कीइंग में काफ़ी मज़ा आ रहा है, डिफरेंट एडवेंचर है यहाँ पे. स्केटिंग करके आए हैं ऊपर, अभी स्कीइंग कर रहे हैं, काफ़ी मज़ा आ रहा है.
Besides enjoying adventure activities, one can grab a quick bite or sip a hot cup of coffee at the multi-cuisine restaurant opened in the park while enjoying the pleasant weather. Visitors can also enjoy riding yak while exploring this magical land of Kufri. With rolling hills and soothing lush greenery all around, covering Kufri on the yak back is something one would remember for life.
Since we are traveling for the first time, it is totally a new and a memorable experience for us.
Yeah, trust me, it's one of the best places to visit at this particular point of time. The snow, the ice, basically, we are from south, so we are not aware about these kind of the weather, the atmosphere over here. So I'm enjoying like crazy right now, and I personally tell everyone, visit this place at this particular point of time, December, Christmas and New Year, it'll be the best experience of your life till date.
Kufri is one such tourist destination that pulls out people from shared environment of conventional pleasure trips and unfolds before them an exciting new scenario of complete leisure destination. And in the last few decades, its popularity has eventually grown, attracting tourists from across the globe. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a hub of several such tourist destinations that we will continue to explore in our section of Incredible India. So that's all we have for you in this week's episode. Till we see you next week, it's a goodbye from the entire production team.